If you want to learn how to measure and plot temperatures, build wireless radio controllers, use servos to drive tools, or build weird things like, I don't know, a thermal camera, here, you'll learn mechatronics in minutes. In the last session, we learned how to use analog write to vary LED brightness and control the speed of a small fan. This week, we'll learn how to do something simple, like turn a LED or a fan on or off. The command we're going to learn today is digital write. And as you can imagine from my digital read tutorial, we can write a low or high. The arguments are simple. You supply the pin and the state, and the MCU performs the operation. Digital write only works on digital pins, and on the Arduino, those are labeled 0 through 13. Depending on the board, some analog pins can be used for a digital. In either case, you really can't use pins 0 or 1 as those are reserved for the USB communications and can't have anything connected to them when programming. If you need to write signals to several pins, a Teensy may be a better choice. On a Teensy 4.0, you have 23 easily accessible pins and another 8 on the bottom. Depending on your project, you may need to upgrade to a Teensy. Let's toggle an LED on or off. The wiring diagram has 3 pins connected to the red, green, and blue LEDs. And a 220 ohm series resistor is used to limit the current to prevent LED burnout. The code is pretty straightforward. A pin mode will first be used to designate the pins as output. Then we'll use 2, 3, and 4 to drive the colors. Inside the loop, we'll simply toggle the red LED on, then the blue, then the green. We'll add a few more sections to create white, cyan, purple, and yellow colors. Note the usage of these manifest constants so we can easily change pin number if we need to. A delay of, say, 1 second should give us enough time to see the sparkling effects. Let's upload the code and watch them flash. Like I said, nothing fancy, and this is basically the blink example that ships with most MCUs. The same approach can be used to toggle a fan on or off through a transistor. The same schematic used in my analog write example will be used here. A digital pin will be connected to the base of a 2N2222 that will control the fan's current. This code is used to toggle the fan on or off. A pin mode designates the output pin, and a digital write with a delay to cycle the fan. And as you can expect, the results are pretty basic. A practical application would be to measure the temperature with a thermistor using analog read, then turn on or off a cooling fan with digital write. A common question is how to turn a device on or off that runs on AC, like a large fan or a light bulb. Being able to do this is a fundamental concept needed to make your home automation system. There are discrete components that can be used to drive AC devices with a digital signal, but a down and dirty approach will be a simple relay. The ones shown here are prepackaged with all the components needed to prevent the noise from the energizing relay's coils. This unit is a bit more elaborate and includes an opto-isolator to keep activity on the relay side insulated from the MCU. This schematic shows the wiring of our light circuit. Power is supplied to the relay along with a digital input signal. There are 2 wires feeding the light. One is the line and the other is the neutral. It's common practice in most parts of the world to break the line side, so we'll follow that convention and break the line side of this light bulb. Caution! We are using 120 volts AC, so touching any of the wires or contacts on the relay could get you shocked, killed, or even worse, damage your Teensy MCU. Proceed with caution and at your own risk. Note, the relay has 3 terminals. A common, normally open, and normally closed. Normally open and normally closed refer to the contact state when the input signal is off. The supply line will get connected to the common, and the light line will get connected to normally open. That way, the light will be off when the digital signal is low. Code is simple, and we'll use the same code we used for the blinking program. A digital write will toggle the light on or off with about a 2-second delay. As expected, see how the light, you know, toggles on and off. I can't really think of any challenges with digital write. The command is simple to implement, and I've not seen issues with bouncing, misfires, or anything else. Because of its simplicity, maybe that's why most tutorials start with the blinking program. Well, that covers this week's lesson. If you learned something, give me a thumbs up. If you have a tip to share, leave a comment so my subs can learn more. Thanks for watching.